Welcome everyone. Today we are going to see earth station subsystems. As in the previous lecture, for earth stations we have seen the role of an earth station, types of earth station, and now we are going to see the earth station subsystems. We know that the earth segment of satellite communication system mainly consists of three earth stations. There are these three categories are transmit and receive type. The earth station can transmit signal for satellite and receive signal from the satellite. These stations are used for two-way communication like telephony or data transfer. Receive only type of earth stations can only receive the signal from a satellite and could not send to the satellite. And mostly used are CATV systems, are receive only type of stations. Transmit only type, here the earth stations can transmit signal only towards the satellite, and these are mostly used in the data collection systems like in navigation, for surveillance of earth surface. I will see the earth station subsystems. For designing an earth station, it always depends not only on the location of the earth station but also on some of the other factors. Here the location of earth station may be on earth, it may be on air, spacecraft, so anywhere, it is not only related to the earth surface. So the depending factors are of type service providing, frequency band utilization, transmitter, receiver and antenna characteristics. The ground station or earth station is the terrestrial base of the system. The ground station communicates with the satellite to carry out the designated mission. So as we know that there are four major subsystems that are present in any earth station, and these are the transmit subsystem, the receive subsystem, antenna subsystem, tracking subsystem and the power subsystem. We'll see its block diagram here first. From the terrestrial network, we are receiving signal to the baseband equipment and then given to the transmitter subsystem. The transmit subsystem will include MUX, that is an encoder, then it will give some error coding techniques, and then modulator, it will modulate the signal to the intermediate frequency and given to the up converter, which will connect it to a local oscillator LO. Now up converter will convert the intermediate frequency to the high frequency. We know that for a satellite, when we are transmitting the signal, it will require very high uplink frequency. Again, these signals are given to the high power amplifier and then transmitted. At the receiver side, we see that in the block diagram, the same antenna we are using for the reception of the signal, and that will be given to the tracking equipment and also to the low noise amplifier at the receiver side. This low noise amplifier gives its output to the down converter with some local oscillator. Now RF frequency is converted to the intermediate frequency by the down converter, and these signals will be given to the demodulator. This demodulator will perform the opposite operation of modulator. As everyone knows how the satellite communication system will work, demodulator will give signal to the DMUX or decoder and then given to the baseband equipment and then reaches to the terrestrial network. Now we'll see one by one how these subsystems will work: transmit subsystem, receive subsystem, tracking subsystem, antenna subsystem, and lastly the power subsystem. The transmit subsystem, the digital information in the form of some binary digits from the terrestrial network enter into the earth station and is then processed. That process may include filtering, multiplexing, or it may be get formatted by the baseband equipment. The encoder performs error correction coding to reduce the error rate by introducing extra digits into the digital stream generated by the baseband equipment. The extra digits carry information. The presence of noise and non-ideal nature of any communication channel produces error rate is established, above which the received information is not stable. The function of the modulator here is to accept this symbol stream from the encoder and use it to modulate an intermediate frequency carrier. This intermediate frequency carrier frequency is chosen at 70 MHz with the help of a low poly oscillator for communication using a 36 MHz transponder bandwidth, and at 140 MHz for a transponder bandwidth of 54 or 72 MHz. The intermediate frequency is needed because it is very difficult to design a modulator that works at the uplink frequency of 6 GHz or 14 GHz directly. So we are using here the modulator. The modulated intermediate frequency carrier is fed to the up converter and frequency translated to the uplink radio frequency. This modulated RF carrier is then amplified by the high power amplifier to a suitable level for transmission and radiation by the antenna to the satellite. Now this antenna will send the signal to the satellite, which is at the radio frequency. At the receiver end, now the receiver system will work. On the receiver side, the earth station antenna receives the low level modulated RF carrier in the downlink frequency spectrum. The low noise amplifier is used to amplify the weak received signal and improve the signal to noise ratio. As we are receiving signal from the far distance, some of the noise will get included into the original signal. So that we have to use here low noise amplifier that will amplify the weak signals and improve its signal to noise ratio. The error rate requirement can be met more easily with the help of this. The radio frequency is to be reconverted to intermediate frequency, that is near about up to 70 or 140 MHz, because it is easier to design a demodulator to work at these frequencies than that modulator will work at 4 or 12 GHz. So that we are using reconverter. The demodulator estimate which of the possible symbols are transmitted based on observation of the received intermediate carrier. In the receive system, the decoder performs a function which is opposite to that of the encoder, because the sequence of symbols recovered by the demodulator may contain some of the errors. Decoder must use the uniqueness of the redundant digits introduced by the encoder to correct the errors and recover information bearing digits. The information stream is fed to the baseband equipment for processing for delivery to the terrestrial network. The tracking equipment track the satellite and align the beam towards it to facilitate communication. Now the third type of subsystem is the antenna subsystem. Here we know that the most important component of an earth station, through which the transmitter and receiver of earth station establishes link with the satellite, is antenna subsystem. An earth station antenna should have high directive gain, low noise temperature, and which is easily steerable. It is essential that the antenna must focus its radiatory energy into a narrow beam to eliminate the satellite antenna in both the transmit and receive modes to provide the required uplink and downlink carrier power. Okay, so that the antenna should have large side lobe in the radiation pattern to avoid the interference of unwanted signal of the other satellites. The low noise temperature of antenna provides better carrier to noise ratio. At the same time, we can say that the antenna must be easily steerable so that a tracking system may be employed to point the antenna beam accurately towards the satellite, taking into account the satellite's drifting position. This also minimizes the pointing loss. The paraboloid reflectors with the feed at its focus and the cast grain antenna are the two kinds of antenna which are mostly used in the earth station. The reflector or dish antenna have the advantages that they offer a wide range of gain values with affordable mechanical complexity. For reflectors, generally we can use the horn antennas and parabolic reflectors. Since we know that in this satellite earth stations, we are using the earth station antenna are field systems and antenna reflectors. That field system and antenna reflectors, two parts combined together radiates or receives the electromagnetic waves. Since this field system obeys reciprocity theorem, the earth station antennas are suitable for both the transmitting and receiving electromagnetic waves. As we have seen that parabolic reflectors are used as the main antenna in the earth stations, and also we can go for the horn antennas. The gain of these reflectors are very very high, and because of this reason, as they will have very high gain and also ability of focusing parallel beam into a point at the focus where the field system is located. These are some of the advantages that make the to use the parabolic reflectors. So this is how the different types of field antennas we can use here for antennas: axial or front field, off axis or offset field. So these are antenna field antennas, and some cast grain antenna for Gregorian antennas that can be used as an antenna subsystem. The tracking subsystem is the fourth type of main subsystem. The tracking subsystem keeps track with the satellite and makes sure that the beam comes towards it in order to establish the communication. The tracking system present in the earth station perform mainly two functions. Those are satellite acquisition and tracking of satellite. This tracking can be done in one of the following ways, that those are automatic tracking, manual tracking or program tracking. We'll see the first term, that is satellite acquisition. Before communication can be established, it is necessary to acquire a satellite. One method is to program the antenna to perform a scan around the predicted position of the satellite. The automatic tracking is switched on when the receiver signal strength is sufficient to lock the tracking receiver to the beacon. Now, the automatic tracking system, after acquisition, a satellite needs to be tracked continuously. Means once we acquired one of the satellite, now we have to track for that satellite. This tracking function is performed by the automatic tracking system, where auto track system are closed loop control systems and are therefore highly accurate. This tracking mode is the preferred configuration when accuracy is the dominant criteria. The manual track system is to avoid a total loss of communication due to a failure in the tracking system. Earth stations generally also have the manual mode. In this mode, an antenna is moved through manual commands, or we can also go for the program track. In the program tracking mode, the antenna is driven to the predicted satellite position by a computer. The satellite position predictions are usually supplied by the satellite operators. It may be noted that since a program track system is an open loop control system, its accuracy is mainly governed by the accuracy of the prediction data. Now we can see here the tracking system diagram. The communication satellites transmit a beacon which is used by the earth station for tracking. The received beacon signal is fed into the auto track receiver. We can see in the diagram there is antenna, and antenna feed is given here. So once we receive the beacon to the antenna or field system, that will feed to the auto track receiver, where the tracking corrections or in some auto track system estimated positions of the satellites are derived. Now these estimated positions are given to the antenna control system, and this antenna control system will be used the program track data, or it will be used the manual tracking systems, and then the signal will be given to the servo amplifier and antenna drive. In this way, the satellite tracking system will work. In other words, we can say that auto track techniques feed system provides the required component of error signal. The output of autotrack receiver are processed and used to drive each axis of the antenna to the estimated satellite position. Whereas antenna control system will also be driven by the manual mode. In the manual mode, an operator sets the desired angle for each axis of a control console. This position is compared with the actual antenna position obtained through the shaft encoders, and the difference signal is used to drive the antenna. In the program track mode, the desired antenna position is obtained from a computer, and the difference in the desired antenna position constitutes the error and is used to drive the antenna. Now, the telemetry subsystem or telemetry and control subsystem. The telemetry equipment consists of a receiver and the recorder and indicator that displays the telemetry signals. The signal may be received by the main antenna or a separate telemetry antenna. A separate receiver or telemetry antenna on a frequency different from that of the communication channel is used for telemetry purposes. The electronic equipment used to deal with the information transmitted back to the earth station. This telemetry will use for the control of the antenna positions and for the acquisition of the satellites. The main subsystem is the power subsystems, which will be used to drive the all other subsystems. The most important station or subsystem in the earth station is the power subsystem. Most earth stations receive their power from the normal AC mains. Standard power supplies convert the AC power to the DC voltages required to operate all subsystems. The most earth stations have backup power systems that take over if an AC power failure occurs. The backup power system may consist of a diesel engine driving an AC generator, which automatically starts when AC power fails. Smaller systems may use uninterruptible power supplies, that is UPS, which derive their main power from the batteries. So, in these subsystems, we have seen the different types of subsystems used to control the satellite communication, mainly the transmitter subsystem, receive subsystem, then antenna subsystems, tracking subsystem, and other two subsystems that will be also we discussed here are telemetry and control system subsystem and power control subsystem. Now, in this lecture, we have seen how the earth stations will work and how its subsystems will be helped for the communication. In the upcoming lectures, we will see the how actually the telemetry tracking and the other subsystems of satellite communication will work.